happening now, there has been a lot of criticism of the president and his handling of the Libyan offensive. It's been criticism coming from his own party as well as the right. But there are also many supporters as well, among them Human Rights Watch, which is arguing the president is not getting the credit he deserves for averting a humanitarian crisis in Libya before it actually happened. Tom Malinowski is the Washington director of Human Rights Watch, and he's our guest today. Tom, you know, I'm familiar with your work as your source in a lot of different wire stories that come out of the Middle East about what's actually happening on the ground, but our viewers may not be as familiar with what your group does. So tell us a little bit about Human Rights Watch.
We monitor human rights abuses in countries all over the world. We've got folks on the ground in most of the countries in the Middle East that have experienced uprisings. We have two people right now in eastern Libya who've been there since the rebellion started and who've been reporting to us about what's happening on the ground.
We've used this term humanitarian crisis quite freely to describe the situation in a lot of different places around the region. How would you define a humanitarian crisis?
I think when the civilian population is under great distress, when people are being killed, when they're being driven from their homes. And that's what we were afraid was going to happen if Qaddafi's forces had reached Benghazi, the capital of eastern Libya. We were afraid that there would have been terrible bloodshed within the city as the two sides fought for control over it, and that once Qaddafi had taken control of Benghazi, he would have hunted down the people who supported the democratic opposition there, imprisoned them, disappeared them, and in many cases executed them.
What do you say, Tom, to people who say, listen, we don't know. This guy's been in power for 40 years. Yes, he's a bad man. He's done a whole lot of horrible things, but we don't know exactly what would have happened. What do you say to critics like that?
Well, you never know exactly what's going to happen, and you know, but if you wait until it happens, then it's too late. You know, in Bosnia, we waited 3 years to intervene after the genocide that happened there. That was 3 years too late. Had we done so before it started, we would have saved hundreds of thousands of lives. So you never know, but I think there were many indications that had Qaddafi taken Benghazi, he would have done what he actually said he was going to do, to show no more mercy to the people there.
What about other places in the region? For example, we heard from Yemen last week that snipers were taking out people that were demonstrating in the streets. We've seen that certainly in Syria as well. What about the other places in the region and whether or not we should get involved? Should we be going in there as well?
Well, I wouldn't say we should go in militarily to every country in the world that's experiencing repression. There are other ways that the United States can make a difference. We don't have the capacity to invade every country that's undergoing these problems. But I think Libya was a unique case. Here was a country where people were being gunned down, not just by police officers, but by helicopters, by planes, by tanks, by artillery. A country where the people had called out to the United States for help. Mm-hmm. A country where we have this broad coalition. The United Nations authorized the use of force. France, the UK, Turkey, Qatar, were willing to stand there with us. I think when all of these factors come together, that suggests that, you know, this is a case where we could have and should have, and I'm glad we did act.
You know, Tom, I'm going to be speaking to the ambassador from the U.S. to the United Nations, Susan Rice, coming up in just about a half an hour. And the big question that a lot of our viewers have is where should we be watching next? Where is the next crisis going to emerge where the United States is going to get involved or should get involved, whether it's militarily or not? What area are you watching specifically? What's the top of your list?
Well, let's set aside the military action, but we're very carefully watching the situation in Syria, in Yemen, in Bahrain, even in Saudi Arabia, where there is a protest movement. There is a wave of democratic protest movements spreading throughout the Middle East. And, you know, now that it's clear, I think, that Qaddafi is going to lose, I think those movements still have life, and it's important that the United States support those people who are standing up for their freedom, as President Obama promised that he would last night.
And the way we support him, of course, as you so rightly point out, is something that we're going to be talking a lot about. Tom Malinowski, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much.